Hey guys, welcome to the first episode of my series, Unraveling the Secrets of Aim. Remember to subscribe and I hope you guys enjoy.
Pool of... This is where...
Matty O.W.
unraveled the mysteries of...
Aim training.
This is the birthplace of...
Aim.
Madbadman, or MBM for short, is arguably the most successful player in all of AIM training. With over 58,000 in total earnings from AIM competitions, this makes him quite the admirable player. That being said, MBM has a rather unique approach to dynamic clicking. Let me show you what I mean.
You look lonely.
At first glance, this doesn't look too special, but when you compare it closely to some of my passive runs or other great passive players, this technique is clearly different. Notice how MBM is almost never intentionally leading his shots, and is playing extremely reactively, not trying to exploit predictable bot movements, but instead just trying to actively kill them as fast as humanly possible. Also notice how MBM's accuracy is very low, as he is practically spam clicking. This approach to aim training is called the MBM method. Something that MBM himself describes as active aiming, which attempts to treat scenarios like passive as if they were real under pressure situations, in which you would be doing things often not advised in most aim training methods, like clicking on flick landings or following singular bots for extended periods of time. There's a reason why this technique really works, but it's not for everyone and not for every scenario. But it is worth studying. Even if you can't adapt to the entirety of the MBM method, you can still combine certain aspects of MBM's philosophy with what you already know about dynamic clicking scenarios to develop a technique that both incorporates his fast movements while maintaining good accuracy and pacing. Before we dive in, I'd like to strongly emphasize that this technique is for advanced players. Although there's some useful info you can take away from this technique, it's not something you should be learning in full until you're at least GM or Nova level in dynamic clicking and reactive tracking. It's also not something you should focus on that much unless you're trying to push yourself in Aimbeast, as Aimbeast dynamic clicking scenarios are the only real place nowadays where this technique applies the most. Also because MBM has a hand in the development of Aimbeast. The MBM method often goes against common aiming advice. The first way it diverges is with clicking on flick landings, which we will refer to as full flicks for the rest of this video. This movement basically throws out the Bardos method. When you make your initial flick, you will click as soon as it lands, with no microcorrection or target confirmation. The best way you can practice this is with One Wall, One Target Evo, RCNT, in Aimbeast, or the AimLab clone of it, VT Spider Snap. These scenarios feature a first or primary target that will always spawn in the center, which, after killed, will spawn a secondary target at some other random location that you must reach and kill as fast as possible. The right way to play it is to perform the usual Bardos method on the secondary target, but then to perform a full flick back to the primary target. Doing this reinforces the main component of the MBM method that allows for its high speed. Also, to visually see what the MBM method should look like, you can play ball sheet variants. Randomness is intrinsic to the more advanced dynamic clicking scenarios. You can get easy clusters for an entire run, or really unlucky wall and ceiling spawns for an entire run. The MBM method takes advantage of randomness by taking full flicks as gambles. After killing one target, simply pick any random target that you can find immediately in your peripheral, and perform a full flick to that one. If it hits, great job, do it again. By accepting randomness in these movements, it benefits you more than just trying to predict and lead shots and use movement reading, because it proves so much faster. The more evasive and spread out targets become, the more efficient it gets to use the MBM method and rely less on singular target movement reading. It's important to designate the scenarios where this technique works, because there are only a few, and trying to perform this technique on a scenario where it does not work will just punish you and impede your improvement. We've already seen passive small reload. Remember how the MBM method is spammy in nature. What this means is that you need a large mag size to compensate. Only dynamic clicking scenarios that give you a lot of ammo and do not have an accuracy penalty will work for this method. Other times, it may be simply less efficient to use the MBM method in certain scenarios. For example, if the targets are very large or are not very evasive, there's no reason to try and force a method that will make you miss more than you need to. On scenarios like VT Passu, this technique fails to keep up with the more steady pacing of what is considered to be proper dynamic technique. Scenarios like RA Snapclick give you an idea of the kinds of movements you should expect from bots that would suggest the use of the MBM method. These bots have no acceleration or deceleration that will visually give away a change in direction. They are extremely evasive in nature, and it would simply take too long to try and read each of them individually. It's just far too slow. Now, this is the point where I should mention that this technique may have some risks to it. Executing it properly looks very similar to brute forcing aim scenarios, and moving this fast should understandably lead to wrist health issues. MBM himself suffers from a lot of wrist fatigue and pain. For this reason, I do not advise anyone to solely focus on this method of aiming. It's good to know, but certainly not good to do for a long time. Now the question is, why is this useful knowledge? If the MBM method only truly works for a select few scenarios mostly found in Aimbeast, then what's the point? Well, the problem with the MBM method is that its core doesn't really take into account the most important factor that is involved in every multi-target aim training scenario. This problem is pretty easy to fix, and requires an understanding of pacing. When I say pacing, I'm referring to the frequency of hits you get in an aim training scenario. Many dynamic clicking scenarios benefit from having static pacing, which means that your frequency or rhythm of hits throughout the run does not fluctuate. It stays consistent. This is different from static clicking, which benefits from dynamic pacing, or varying the amount of hits you get at different points during the run. The reason why dynamic clicking benefits from static pacing is because it is far easier to balance movement reading and hold a steady rhythm over trying to fluctuate your pacing every few seconds for a burst in speed. Those bursts usually just end with a string of misses, or, God forbid, a reload. The MBM method is dynamically paced because it is random and relies on clusters of targets to make for easy strings of hits. A lot of times, this leads to brief moments of downtime in scenarios like 5 targets pass through smooth in Aimbeast, where you're failing to hit any targets. The more improved approach to the MBM method is to try and force a static pacing. This can be done on 5 targets pass through smooth by recognizing the horizontal strafe patterns of the bots and delaying your full flicks by micro-correcting in the bot's next strafe direction. This should take a while to get right, but once you have the right rhythm, it's insanely easy to keep for a long interval of the run. A better example is RA Snapclick, which we've already mentioned. Snapclick is a weird exception. The MBM method works here because of the inherent randomness of the bots, but it technically shouldn't work because of the accuracy penalty. To get the highest score on Snapclick, the best way is to use the improved MBM method and try to incorporate minimal reading to hold a static pace. This has been the first episode of Unraveling the Secrets of Aim. Hope you guys learned something. Good luck copying the MBM method. Don't break your wrists in the process. Also, thank you guys so much for 5,000 subscribers. I know this video is insanely late and 100% would have made this earlier if it was not for final exams. Anyways, see you guys in the next one. Happy dot clicking.